Hey yo together and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replays today on Odyssey Letter Edition with a TVC. Let me just check that it's working, that is well awesome. So on the top left hand side, the blue circle for ECV, it's Freddy Wee Wee. Or Freddy Wee Wee. Freddy. So, in the bottom right hand side, it's me, the red Terran, Alex Usher. Woo! I'm still somewhat active. The fun part is I need to have a look on the sounds. I think it's fine. The fun part is that while I'm now learning, sometime, I just feel like, meh, maybe I should play some StarCraft 2. So that's why I went for on an A to not ruin my sweet Europe MMR. It's like cheating, but I don't care. And as I said, I'm playing mech only there. And actually, it's quite some fun to just someday just try something different, experiment. And is it called widen your horizon? No, expand. Expand your horizon.
Oh yeah,
Nailed it. So that's what I'm trying with the mech style. I could also play just Protoss or Zerg and try some variations there, but those are not the races I feel comfortable with. So I just stick with Terran, and why not play sweet mech? And the fun part is you can't play turtleneck like it was possible or maybe even necessary in Heart of the Swarm. No. You need to play aggressive mech, non-stop harassment, go for the worker, go for the drones. Against Protoss, useless, I know. But against Zerg, it can work. Against Terran, however, turtle mech is somewhat possible. That's the good thing. If you play TVT, you can go for the turtle mech style. At some point, that completely no, but a mixture. Some more defensive oriented next time. Against Zerg or Protoss, no way, you need to play aggressive. If you turtle, just take the map and it's cheap. But here? Ah, that's nice. Oh, so close, not getting any circling, that's so painful. But I'm greedy as hell, I'm so greedy. Can I get more? Yes! Two circlings die. And be annoying against the queen. Nice. Okay, it's not overextending. That's good. Oh, I'm going for the circling. Oh, and I get it. Now he has not enough circlings. Ooh, 4 kills. Never ever should you lose those circlings against the Reaper. No. It happens, but normally in this league you should never lose your circlings against one Reaper. Two or three, yes, but not against one. And not all four. That's especially not when the queen is out. So, but it's okay. Freddy, we tried his best. I just did overcome him a little bit. And in this game, as it was played on Europe, oh god, I'm getting drone kills. Ooh, that's so painful. This Reaper is gold, man. He's golden. Will he be golden? That's the question. Will he get out? He could have gotten out. No, he's dead. Okay. Never mind. But I'm going for bio asset. Europe server, non-mech play here. Maybe I could... go for some mech on Europe as well. But I want to experiment with on NA first. See the strengths and weaknesses. What I figured out is... Even more than with bio, spending your money is so difficult. With bio, okay, you got overgas, bam, just go for some marauder, tech up, get the upgrades, bam, bam, bam. With mech, it's a little bit different, as everything is gas heavy already. I mean, unless the SCVs and the Hellions. You bank up a lot of minerals early on. And you can't spend them on a lot of factories, because if I go, For example, okay, there's the double drop. If you go, it's so late. Normally I could be on 4:30 with the double drop and 60 marines there, but whatever. Oh, that's the super all-in version. If you want to have this build, it works up to master or even GM. It's so strong. Just get the production tab and have a look. It's super strong. Or maybe go for zombie grubs 2-1-1 on YouTube. You can find it there. It's a YouTube video. Detailed, described, it's good. And losing those marines unnecessarily, that's bad. You shouldn't lose those marines. Never ever should you. But yeah, with the mech style, the thing is, you don't bank up gas. So especially if you go for Thor or Battlecruiser openings, or maybe Liberator opening as well, it doesn't matter. You can't really pump up a lot of factories, and even if you do so, you don't have gas to go for anything else than Hellions, so that's bad. At least for me, how I played. Maybe I played wrong, but for now I'm winning even against Tier 1 Master League. And I have to say, Mech, even though it's doable, I don't think it's very strong unless you're some Gumi God. Gumiho is really playing good Mech in TVC. I saw Innovation playing a little bit of Mech successfully, but not as good as Gumiho if I'm not wrong. And Maru tried it as well, but wasn't very successful either. Oh, the drones! Woohoo! They are so lucky! But yeah, that's a problem. The Balingness, as you can see in the production tab, is super late. And there's them. And normally, yeah, you see it. You are at 110 supply if you wouldn't have lost anything. At 6 minutes, 6:30, all the drones go down. That's instant GG. So, counterattack, that's nice. But oopsie. But even if you killed everything there, I got Hellions, Hellbats, I got a Strong Force, where are the Banelings? Not there, Baneling Nest killed, I think. And that's game. So, this build, I'm not sure if it was 110 supply at the 6 minute mark. Maybe it was at 6:30, but even then it's impressive. Sorry. Ooh. Wow. But that's really nice. So this build, however, if there are roaches or banelings, it gets really difficult to deal damage with it. It's not full all-in, but it's more all-in than the standard 2-1-1. Oh, cancelled! Oh, but it doesn't matter, look at the Hellbats. You still can transition out of it and go for a third command center, which you're doing, but it's somewhat all-in if you don't deal damage. Barbecue time! So nice. If you don't deal damage, you're dead, basically, because Zerg will just steamroll with the economy, get you to crush you with a maxed out Ling Bane flood, and you're dead. But otherwise, as you can see, very strong. And if you can't keep the Reaper alive, scout for the gases. In this case, now 3 gases, but at this point in time, it's normal to have that amount of gas, I would say. But if you scout with the Reaper, don't lose it, and can keep the Reaper alive up until the 4 minute mark, that's where you can shine with this build. If you can know, okay, what's going on, no roaches, that's a big factor. Banelings you can split and kite and focus fire, it's possible, but against roaches this build falls off heavily. So, and then you are stuck on Hellbats and Marines against roaches. If you go for Roach Ravager, that's a huge bam, it's so bad. But you can try it, give it a shot. So that's that, thank you so much for watching, hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions, put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care, bye bye.